Good day everyone. So sa video na to, i-discuss ko yung solution ng exam nyo kahapon. Okay. So meron tayong two problems, but I will discuss the item number 2. Okay. Kasi yung item number 1 puro rectangles. Dito sa item number 2 is composed of different shapes. So meron tayong triangles, semicircle, rectangles na nakikita dito sa problem natin. Anyway, kung ano yung step na gagamitin natin dito, same naman din dun sa number 1. Pinili ko yung number 2 kasi mas challenging siya kasi nga yun, composed of different shapes. Okay, but the steps is just the same. Okay? So, let's start. So, meron tayong apat na tanong na per item. So, determine the location of the centroid referred from the y-axis and then number 2 is referred from the x-axis. So, dito maraming nagkamali, no? Na pagbaliktad nila yung x and y. So, dito sa number 1, from the y-axis. So, kunwari nandito yung centroid natin. No? Kunwari lang naman yan. Referred from the y-axis. Ibig sabihin, ang reference point natin or the reference line is yung ating y-axis. So, ito yung y-axis natin. So, ito yung kukunin nyo. Yan. So, that is the x-bar. And then, sa number 2, referred from the x-axis, ang magiging reference point nyo or reference line is the x-axis. So, ito naman. And that is the y-bar. Okay? So, sa unang tanong, ang hinahanap dito is the x-bar. Tapos, dito naman is the y-bar. Okay? So, let's start. So, itong shape natin is composed of different shapes or itong ating example today is composed of different shapes. So, ang gagawin natin dyan is to divide the whole geometric shape into smaller ones. Magkakaroon tayong ng mga regular shape. So, dito, meron tayong triangle. Shape number 1 natin is triangle. Shape number 2 is a rectangle ito. Tapos, ima-minus natin yung shape naman na to. So, we have here a semicircle plus a rectangle. Okay. Semicircle and rectangle. So, shape number 1. Triangle. Number 2 is the larger rectangle. 3, semicircle. Tapos, 4 shape is the smaller rectangle. Okay? So, dito, kukunin natin yung area. Tapos, yung individual location ng kanilang mga centroids. Okay. So, sa area 1 natin, we have a triangle. So, we have 1/2. Base natin is 490 times 2 or 980. And then, height is 420. So we have 205,800. By the way, yung mga unit natin dito is millimeter. Square millimeter yan, tapos 2 millimeter. Ah nga pala, maraming set yung exam ninyo. So ang difference lang naman dun is yung mga reference axis natin. So for this one, nandito yung axis niya. Yung iba siguro yung axis nandito sa part na to or pwedeng nandito. Okay. So anyway, yung solution naman dyan is just the same. May mga babaguhin lang kayong location of the reference point ng mga axis natin. Yung distance lang naman yung mag-iiba dun. No? Okay. So let's continue. X-bar natin. So nandito yung axis. Ayan. So, kung individual centroid yung kinukuha natin muna, nandito yung centroid niya. Okay. So, sa x bar natin, so basically, nandito lang yan sa gitna, no? Ito yung axis. So, ang maying sagot natin dyan is 490. And then, y bar. So, from this point, ito yung centroid natin for that shape. So, from this point, papunta dito. Ano yung distance na yan? So that is 280 plus 280. So 280 plus 280 plus, so meron tayong triangle, so that will be equal to 1/3 of the height for 20. Plus 1/3 of 420. So that is equal to 700. 700 millimeter. Okay, next. The larger rectangle. So the area is equal to, ano yung base niya? So we have 300 plus 140 plus 120. So that is 560. So 560 times 280 times 2. Okay. So that is equal to 313,600. 313,600. Okay, next. X bar. So X bar natin from this point. Okay. Kung makikita nyo, ito yung ating axis. Ito yung axis natin yan. Yan, axis. So from this point, papunta sa centroid nitong larger triangle or larger rectangle. So ilan yan? Kung 560 yung kabuuan, so hatiin natin. So we have 560 divided by 2 plus 560 lang yan plus ano yung distance nito papunta dito. So that is equal to, so kung ang kabuuan ng shape na to is 980, so magkakaroon tayo ng 980 minus 560 divided by 2. Okay. 980 minus 560 divided by 2. So that is equal to 210. So 210 to na. 210. And also this is 210. So plus 210. That is equal to 490. Okay, next, Y bar natin. So Y bar, the height, total height of this rectangle is also 560. Therefore, 560 divided by 2. That is also 280. Okay? Yan. That is square lang pala, hindi pala rectangle. Square. Okay. And the next, punta naman tayo sa semicircle natin. So for our semicircle, kulang lang natin yung area of the circle divided by 2. No. So area of the circle, tignan muna natin kung ano yung magiging. Ayan, given na pala. Diameter is 140 diameter. So gamitin na lang natin yung formula na may diameter. So we have pi d squared all over 4 divided by 2 kasi that is a semicircle, di ba? So pi d squared diameter is 140 squared divided by 4 divided by 2. So we have 7, sige, ganito na lang. 2450 pi. 2450 pi. Okay? And then, so sa x bar niya, kukunin lang natin yung radius. So that is 140 divided by 2 plus. So from this centroid niya, papunta dito sa reference natin. So ilan yan? So we have 300 plus 210. 300 plus 210. So we have 580. Yan. And then for the Y bar, meron tayong formula, and then I think binigay ko naman na din yung formula sa inyo. So that is equal to 4/3 R, or 4R divided by 3 pi. 4R divided by 3 pi. So yung 4R divided by 3 pi na yan, ito yun na, di ba? Ito yung semicircle kasi natin eh. So, ito yung kinukuha nyo. So, that is 4R divided by 3 pi plus kung ano man yung distance nito. So, that is 280. Okay. Plus 280. So, substitute lang natin. Ano yung R natin? Radius dyan. 70. So, 4 times 70 divided by 3 pi plus 280. So, that is equal to 309.7089. Okay. And then, for the smaller rectangle here, the area is equal to 140 by 280. So that is equal to 39,200. Tapos yung x bar niya, so kalahati 140 yan, so yung kalahati 70 plus 300 plus 210. 300 plus 210. So that is equal to 580. Okay, and then yung ating y bar. So, yung kalahati lang ng 280. So, 280 divided by 2. So, that is 140. Okay. So, nakompleto na natin yung mga kailangan. And take note, guys. This is a hollow section dito sa part na to. So, ibig sabihin, ima-minus natin yung mga nakuha natin dito sa 3 and 4. Yan. Minus, minus. Okay? So, kunin natin yung summation of the area. 205,800 plus 313,600 minus 2,455 minus 39,200. So the total area is equal to 472,503.098. Okay. And then, i-apply na natin yung formula natin in getting the centroid. So that is equal to area x bar is equal to the summation of the individual shapes na of their area and then yung kanilang centroid. Okay, so the total area is equal to 472,503.098. Tignan natin to sa taas, x bar na tayo ah, so dito, so 490 by 205,800 plus 490 of 313,600 minus tayo dyan, no? Minus 2,455 multiplied by 580 minus 39,200 multiplied by 580. Kalimutan natin isulat yung x-bar. X-bar is equal to, therefore, x-bar or the location of the centroid referred from the y-axis is equal to 481.0673 millimeter. Okay, so ito na yung location ng ating centroid referred from the y-axis. Okay, and then next for our y, so we have a y bar is equal to summation of the area tapos yung kanilang individual location of the centroid. Okay, so 503.098 y bar is equal to 700 by 205,800. 700 plus the shape number 2, 280 times 313,600 minus the area 2,455. Ano yung location? 309.7089 minus 39,200 by 140. Okay, therefore y bar is equal to Double-check lang natin. 700 to 5,800. Plus 280. 313. 600 minus 2,455. Times 3. 409. 0.7089 minus 39,200 times 140 divided by 472,503.098. So we have 474.0629. 474.0629 milliliter. Okay? So ito yung magiging sagot natin for the question number 1 and then question number 2. Okay? And then on the next video, didiscuss ko naman yung pagkuha natin ng moment of inertia.